that's enough. For those of you who were triggered by the last minute and a half of Mozart being played on an electric synthesized instrument, thank you for your patience, if you're still here. But I thought that Mozart would be a really cool way to introduce this, which is the Roland Aerophone Pro AE-30. Now, there have been electronic wind instruments around for the last 35 or 40 years, but this is the very, very first one that actually has clarinet fingerings. And so I picked one of these up. I actually paid for this. I didn't ask Roland. I wanted one. And I think I would give Roland an A for effort. Maybe a B or a B minus for execution. In some ways, this feels kind of like a beta, because, like I said, it's the very first time they tried to put clarinet fingerings on an instrument like this, which also, by the way, has saxophone fingerings, trumpet fingerings, iwi fingerings, recorder fingerings, flute fingerings. I think that's it. But like I said, it's the first one with clarinet fingerings. So thank you, Roland, for trying. I want to share this with those of you who have been interested in playing an electronic wind instrument, but who don't know saxophone fingerings, who don't want to learn saxophone fingerings or recorder fingerings or flute fingerings or whatever, and you want to just play your clarinet fingerings. Will this work for you? So today I'm going to talk about this specifically with a focus on clarinet playing and how successful Roland is with that. If you want to hear about the sounds that it makes, there are like dozens of videos about this instrument, so you can hear all of the different tones and timbres and things like that, the other features that it has, and it has a lot. But no, today we're going to be talking about this as an electronic clarinet, and will it work for you, and is it something that you might want to consider having for your instrument closet? Like I now do. At a high level, I want to tell you a little bit about this instrument, the Roland Aerophone Pro A30. It costs $1,650. It's pretty expensive. It has its own internal built-in synthesizer that is controlled by blowing air through this mouthpiece. Now, this mouthpiece has a reed on it, but the reed doesn't vibrate. It's really just there for you to bite, and if you bite it, it actually moves this little lever here, which will change the pitch if you want it to. I found that that pitch changing was very, very hard to control. It almost always is out of tune, so I just disabled that, which you can do inside the instrument. So squeezing this with my lip doesn't do anything. There is another way to control pitch on here with a sort of pitch bend lever down on your right hand. Anyway, you blow into it, and there is an air sensor on the inside that can tell how hard you are blowing, and it continuously registers the velocity of your air, and it translates that into a signal that the synthesizer can then do something with. In this particular sound, what it does is it makes it louder and softer, which makes sense, but it also closes and opens a filter, so it makes it brighter and darker. Here, let me show you. I find that that degree of nuance between the blowing hard and blowing softly, that dynamic contrast and sound change, it's not just volume, but it's how the instrument responds with filters, is really, really great. I find it to be, obviously it's not playing like a clarinet, but it's doing what I would expect it to. So my brain is tricked into thinking that I'm actually, you know, using my air in the way that it would work on a clarinet. That to me was a game changer. Other wind synthesizers can do that, and they do, but not to this degree of flexibility and nuance. So I was really immediately impressed with that on this instrument. But of course, the thing that was most interesting to me, as I said, is the fact that it uses clarinet fingering. So let's talk about that. So when I took this out of the box, the first thing I did was put it together, put in some batteries, and play it. I wanted to see how much it felt like a clarinet straight out of the box. And like I said, blowing into it and getting the expressive sound out of it from a wind perspective, I was really, really impressed with. The clarinet fingering system, though, not so much, because Roland had to make some trade-offs, right? Because they wanted to make an instrument that would work with saxophone fingerings and flute and trumpet and recorder and iwi and clarinet. And they defaulted to saxophone fingerings. So that causes some issues for clarinet players like me. For example, saxophones have palm keys. Clarinet has a G-sharp key here. The G-sharp key, though, is not played with your palm. It's played with the side of your finger. So when you go from G-sharp to A, it's not this huge distance that you have to go. So if I had to do a G-sharp to A trill, no way, it doesn't work very well. And so when I'm doing anything like an A major or E major where I have to go from G-sharp to A, either up or down, it sounds like crap. It still sounds like crap. I'm getting better. but it still doesn't sound great. So that was a huge trade-off that Roland made that I find to be very, very difficult to overcome as a clarinet player. Now, I'm going to experiment with putting some Sugru on this so that I can extend this palm key up closer to the A key, but still, it doesn't work by pushing down. I still have to push in on the key itself, so I don't think it's ever going to be great. It's a limit to the instrument, and it's one of the trade-offs that Roland made. Another trade-off they made was, like a saxophone, there are only two keys down here for your right pinky, right? So clarinet, you're used to having four keys down here for your right pinky, right? So you have it, we're gonna talk about the low register. You have an A flat, an F sharp, and an E. And you also have a lot of the equivalents on your left pinky. Why? Because we have to go left, right all the time. If you're playing a C sharp up here, and you need to go to an F sharp, you have to be able to play the F sharp with your right pinky. There is no F sharp on this, so you have to play it on your left side. Now that already is a drag, that there's only one F sharp and only one E. The other thing that's a drag is that when you play that F sharp and the E, you have to hold down the F key. Now, as we all know on a clarinet, when you play a low E, you don't have to push down the F key because the mechanism on the clarinet pushes it down for you when you play an E. On this instrument, it doesn't. So when I'm trying to play a low E, I have to push down the F. Let me give you a quick demonstration of what I mean. I'm gonna play an F. Now, if I want to play an E, I would push down this key, just like you would on a clarinet. But if I want to play that E without the F down, nothing, it plays nothing. Same with the F sharp. I have to push down the F key in order to get the F sharp to work. That is a huge pain in the butt. I understand why you did this, Roland. Because most people who are gonna buy these are saxophone players and not clarinet players, but it's still a major drag. And that's not where the fingering drags stop. There are other things that we're used to, like playing one-on-one for a B-flat or an E-flat. Doesn't exist. If you want to play alternate fingerings for your high notes, you're used to playing an altissimo G or an F sharp or G sharp on your clarinet with a certain fingering system. Sorry, there's just one, and it's kind of one that I'm not used to. There's another one. So when I go from C sharp to D, technically, yes, you play a C sharp without venting it with the E flat key, and you play a D with venting it. But I would like to be able to do a trill. No trill. I have to go, shoot me. Now, Roland allows you to add your own fingerings to add notes to this if you want to sort of change the way you play a certain note. I was like, awesome, I can add some of these extra fingerings. I can make this into an F sharp. I can make one and one play B flat or E flat. I was like, oh my God, this is the solution. So I tried to do it and it simply doesn't work. So I reached out to a representative from Roland and they tried it and they're like, wow, you're right. This really doesn't work at all. Hopefully they will fix that in a future software update. I hope you're listening, because that would be great for something in your manual that says can happen to actually work. But what I did do was that I added lower notes that go down to low C, because obviously as a bass clarinet player, low E is not where I want to end. I want to end on a C. Actually, I would love to go lower, but C is the lowest note on this. So what I did was I added a few extra notes. So I had to make up other fingerings for those notes because there are no thumb keys, and I have to get used to that. But at least I invented them, so I can decide how I want to play those notes. The final thing that I think is kind of a disappointment is how loud the keys are. Unlike an Akai Iwi, which just uses a capacitive sensor to tell when your finger is touching a piece of metal, these actually have a button that actuates. Some people like that, right? So I can feel the thing click when I push it down. The problem is, it's really, really clacky and noisy. I mean, even my bass clarinet when it's out of adjustment isn't that loud. Now, yes, I suppose that if you're sort of shredding at a club with your band and you're wailing away on this and it's coming through an amp, you're never gonna hear that. But you know, in some situations, you will. And it's not an especially great chamber music instrument. So with all of those idiosyncrasies, it makes it very difficult to play something fast and chromatic on this. But you know, the point of it is, that's not what this instrument is for. It is not meant for classical chamber music. It's meant for you to play in a live setting, amplified, probably with a guitar or another synthesizer, drums, bass, whatever. Naturally, in those environments, you're not going to be playing Bach. No, you just can't do it. There are too many wrong notes. There are too many fingerings that I use that this instrument doesn't recognize. It just isn't going to work. You know, I have heard a number of saxophone players, predominantly saxophone players I've seen play this, can get around on it with a lot of facility, and they're playing chromatic stuff in jazz idioms just fine. For me, I find it really difficult to play this in classical idiom, but in a jazz situation, I find it a little bit more forgiving. The reason I'm playing classical music here for you in this example is because I know most of the people who watch this channel who are clarinet players are classical clarinet players. So in summary, is this an instrument that most clarinet players are going to want to buy? My answer is no, not yet. There's still a lot of work to be done on Roland's side from a software perspective. I should mention that when this instrument was first released, the hardware, it did not have clarinet fingerings. They added that with the version 2 software, which is when I bought it, because I was like, all right, well, that's pretty cool. They're adding clarinet fingerings. Now, as you can see, there's still a lot of work to be done. There are bugs to be ironed out, like not being able to create user fingerings like they say you should. It's just not working properly. And hopefully they will add some new features, like the ability to use these two bottom register or octave keys on the clarinet fingering system. Why not? You know, there's no reason not to have it. So things like that, I'm assuming, knowing Roland, that they're going to iterate on this and they're going to invest in that and they're going to make this thing better and better and better. If you're willing to go along for the ride with Roland, and I am, I'm keeping this instrument, I think it's pretty cool, buy it, certainly. It's a really amazing synthesizer. The control using wind is really expressive. It has a lot of other features that I didn't even mention. And as a clarinet, it kind of sucks, but hopefully it won't suck forever. So anyway, I hope this was helpful for you. If you've been in the market for one of these things, this is as close as it has ever gotten for a clarinet player. Maybe it's time for you to make the leap. That's something only you can decide. If you have any questions or comments, put them down in the comments section. I will try to address them or reach out to me on my site, earspasm.com/contact, and I will get back to you. In the meantime, hope you have a great day. Thanks for watching.